Good evening, welcome. I'm in a quandary. I've got my favourite beer of all time and one of my least favourite breweries of all time. Look, not a personal thing, but this brewery, I'll tell you where the brewery is, it's Wells and Young's. And a little while ago, they got hold of all, they had a whole gamut of really lovely beers, you know, Courage Directors, you know, the Courage Best, and Bombardier, Banana Bread beer was beautiful, all sorts of, all their beers, the whole range of what they've got, Wells and Young's, and the whole range they've got, they bought out all sorts, you know, and they were all fantastic, lovely beers, and that, really good British beers that you could fly the flag with and go dun 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 like that, you know, and be quite proud of, and that, and they kind of coloured them up with E numbers and messed about with them and completely messed up. Not only a good brewery but good beers as well, you know. So yeah, disappointed and everything with them. And also, they're flying the flag around the world. And people in different countries, especially people like America and all that, you know, they're looking at our brewing and going, right, let's see what is quintessentially British brewing. Let's have a look at an example of British brewing. Sorry, let's just turn that around a bit. There we go. An example of British brewing. Let's see what it's like. And they go, oh, look, this one's got a, you know, England flag on it. And let's try this. And it's all full of all sorts of stuff anyway. If you want to find out more, either go to my blogs or whatever, you know, about these things, and go to the you know, the videos of like Bombardier and things like that, you'll see what I mean, you know. But I had this at the GBBF, this one here, right? And it's another version of that one there kind of thing, you know. And it was extraordinary. And I was quite sick of myself, but it was lovely. Now, I don't believe, it's possible, but I don't believe that they're sticking all sorts of E-numbers in this. I've looked in the back, I can't see it, but they, you know, it depends. If you're exporting to different countries, you have to list it on there, on some countries. I think in supermarkets, you have to list it on there as well, if you're including colouring and stuff like that. And some brewers do use colouring because they're under pressure to keep a uniform product, you know. But there's colouring and there's adding corn and stuff, or, you know, maize or whatever, and then making up for that insipid ingredient by adding sugar and colouring. Now, a strong beer like this is very possibly and very probably made using, and, you know, added sugar as well, same as a lot of the Belgium stuff. Anyway, I do digress. Look, this one and this one here, that's my favourite of all time. I ain't tasted that one yet, apart from at the GBBF on cask, right? And these bottles, these beers are usually better in bottle, the real strong ones I've found anyway. I'm going to try these one against the other. Both kind of stem off of the same recipes and things like that. I think, if I remember rightly, they started, Albert Lecoq started brewing them to export or import, export to Russia. To the Tsar and everything else. One of the Tsarine is, it was the Tsarine's favourite drink, and it's supposed that she could drink any man under the table with them. Oh, I'd give her a go. I bet she was a big old girl, wouldn't she? Anyway, I don't mind that. And here's kind of Barclay Perkins, and Harvey's and everything else, they all got their hands on recipes and bits of, and so, you know, it's been passed down, licensed out. I think it's only these two that have got the license to do it, though. The actual, you know, original. But that can be kind of altered a little bit and changed. You can put different malts in different times and different all sorts of things can be done different and make them totally different beers. So let's crack these open. I am going to be Lord Mayor today, the Lord Mayor of beer. Right, crack one off, Till. Here we go. Now this little gold, this little big red cock on the got on the top here. Sorry, on the courage, they got a big proud cock on the top. I did used to be really proud of him once, you know. As an icon of British brewing, he used to be above pubs and things, usually with a light inside him, and he was a, you know, you'd go, oh, courage, lovely, courage, best beats all the rest. So that's the crown of that. It smells lovely. And I will give it honest opinion. If he beats my baby, I'll be very upset, but I will tell you. And there's my baby. But I will tell you, honestly, I will. I really will. And that's the crown on that. Quite plain. All plain and lovely. Right. Smell very different. That smells more vinous. Right, let's pour them out. Let's get me in the glasses. I'll see if I can pour these on camera for you. That means I've got to work with my arms up in the air. Now, don't look for a big, great big head on these, because you ain't going to get a big head on them. I'm going to pour that up to the sort of halfway. Look at that. Look at the colour of that head. Look at that. Have a look at the colour of that head. Look. It's what you call dark. It's almost a brown head. And let's pour this chap in. Sorry, pour him on. It's not pouring quite so viscous. And it's a lighter head. And a bit fluffier. Right, so. Much, much less viscous, that one. Much less kind of substance. Big bulbous substance on it and that. It's 12. Give this one, let that run settle a minute. That's the kind of head on it. Fluffy, bouncy. Dying down though, like I say, the head ain't going to stay long on these. That's gone down already. That's the Harvey's. And that's gone down already. I'm swirling it, see what happens if the head comes back. Not really, but it's really, really dark. Viscous as well. Oh, Jesus. Right. You got black currants, you got molasses, you got wood even. You got kind of I've got wood smelling it, I have. You got Merlot sort of dark grape notes. Little hints of what's the sticky, always ones that look like turds and they come off, they've got string and sticky things inside. God, what are them little seedy things called? And you get a pulp that you can get in Indian shops and things. God, I can't remember the names of them. You got those in there, but then you got dark notes. You got toffee, you got a little bit of chocolate in there. Really rich, sugary smells. Little rum notes. But very, very berry-like. Very wine-like, almost. Oh, blimey. Big, massive, 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 big. Big, everything's massive. It's a tiny bottle, and it's just huge. Are they both the same size bottle? Two, seven. I think you get... This is 27 centiliters. No, it ain't. Where is it? Oh, 275 millilitres, yeah. 275, the other one's 275, little tiny bottles. But in those little bottles, massive. So that one's massive, that's the Harvey's. This one has already died down as well. Like I said, the head won't stay there for long because it's massive. Oh, this is much, 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 much less. This is a punch in the face. It's like being assaulted with lovely, a big army of massive flavours. The courage. I've got to stick my bugle in there, and it's kind of, let me just twist it in a little bit. See if I can twist a little bit, carefully. Nice, don't get me wrong, but I'm really honestly, you try them side by side, you tell me. Massive amounts of difference on the nose. Massive, massive amounts of difference. That, I'd pay the cost of the bottle just to smell it. You try it and let me know, Harvey's. This one is, maybe it's my mind, but it smells a little bit false. Still smells nice though, but it's really subdued. You got a little hint of kind of a little hint of balsamic vinegar, a little hint of a good balsamic vinegar though. You got a hint of soy sauce, a little hint of Marmite. Not getting massive chocolatey notes, but you're getting a little chocolatey sort of cocoa chocolate edge. And on the nose, it's really subdued. Really quiet on the nose. Right, let's try these out. I don't know what one to go for first. I think go with the Harvey's first again. See, that one I'm shaking the head back into that. This one I'm shaking and there's hardly any head coming back in. Because it is just so viscous. Look at it come down the glass. So let's see what difference coming down the glass. Look at that, look. Watch this, watch. Look at that coming down the glass, look. Now let's see this one. Let's do them together. Can't really tell, but you've got to trust me on that, I think. Can't tell that way either. You can tell by the colouring up the back of that glass. And the colour of the head as well. Just so much substance in it. Right, let's try the Harvey's. Let's try this one first, because I think the Harvey's. If I have the Harvey's first, I ain't going to taste this. I'm thinking from the smell. So let's taste it. This is the courage. Really lovely. Really, really lovely. Beautiful beer. Absolutely glorious. It's absolutely, it's glorious, but it's lacking so many different things that the other one is. And I'm looking forward to the other one. Over the top of this, I'm looking forward to the other one. This one, I could kind of whack it back and sort of, yeah, you know, it's nice, isn't it? And it is nice. It really is. If you buy one of these, you won't be upset. You'll go, wow, that's lovely in a way, you know. And I think I did actually buy it in somewhere, in a supermarket or somewhere, B&M's even, or something like that, for like 150 or 180 or something. Something ridiculous, you know. I was quite pleased with that, you know, because I wasn't going to pay the full price. And I can't really see, if I would have ordered it from Wells and Young's, they would have probably went, go away! Mind you, I've actually, they did say come down and all that, but they said come down when we've taken the colourings and all that out of beers, which they ain't never done, you know. Because they said they're going to go all natural, and they didn't do, you know. They just kind of went, please leave us alone. Right, let's have a sniff, have a taste. See what I can ping you. Right. Big rich notes. You got rich chocolatey notes in there. Rich toffee notes. Really nice beer. Really, really nice beer. Little burnt kind of toast notes and that. Nice. Quite well balanced. Little bit of bitterness. Bitter sort of burnt sugar note in there. And personally, I believe there's a bit of colouring in there as well. But that could just be me. It could just be kind of preconceived thoughts. I don't know. But it tastes slightly of that, you know. They say it's colourless, but it's tasteless, but it ain't. You can taste it in mild beers. There's a slight little zip across the tip of the tongue. That sort of numbing almost, of some sort of hops. Kind of like Fuggles and Golding, sort of, those sort of hops. It's not bad. It's a lovely beer. It's a lovely beer, but it's not in this one's class. Right, let's try this one and see what I can tell you about that. Sorry if this is going on long, but it's an important one. Jesus Christ. Right, straight away, the mouthfeel and that cough. I nearly swore. The mouthfeel on that is like syrup. It's really, really rich. You almost feel like you could pull it away and leave a little string of it behind, you know. Now, if that appeals to you or not, I don't know, you know, but it appeals to me. It's just so much substance in that beer. And that is a true sipper of a beer. Sip, sip, sip. You're not going to want to gulp that. It's massive. There's dark grapes. Really good wine in there. A little hints of rum. There's pipe tobacco. There's hints of kind of cigar tobacco. Not smoked. You know, like wet. You know, just new. If you dip it in something like a rum or something like that. That's lovely. It really is nice. There's little hints of leather. Brand new leather. There's hints of kind of whiskey casks and things like that. Wow, that is something. That is, without a doubt, the best beer you will buy. It's not for the faint-hearted, right? That there, it's not for the faint-hearted, but it is massive, it is big, it is extraordinary. Put some of them by, put them in, away to age and all that business, to mature and age. Put them away for quite a while. They are just extraordinary. I really don't know if I'll show you the difference of kind of our... You can't see any difference. I'm sure you can't. But wait a minute. Let's put that around that way a little bit, so you got the light sort of colour there. See how that just the wishy washy, and that with the light colour behind it clings to that. So wait a minute. Put that one around. Where are we? All right, you got that behind there, right? And watch up that glass behind that dark colour. Look, see it clinging to it almost. Now look at that. One minute. I can't do it left hand. Let's try it that way. Whoosh. Right. And then we'll try this. Watch. See, it's like syrup. See it? So. Thicker on the glass. That's an extraordinary beer. That is massive. That one there. Right, let's hold these up. Really, really nice beer. Really nice beer. Absolutely fantastic beer. So nice beer. Really nice beer. absolutely fantastic beer, best beer I've ever tried. Try them against each other. You buy them, both of them. Probably get them from the breweries. Order them down. Try them against each other. Look, that one, I think you have to order a case of it. Do so. Do so. Even if you ain't into it now, after trying enough different beers, you'll go, oh, wow, I've got to try another one of them. And then you will appreciate it. I think you have to earn your wings in kind of tasting beers. So this is the Russian, that one, the pretty little label on it. That's the courage one. That's really nice. Cheers, bombs up, chin chin. Cheers. See you in the next one. Don't be late. I will start without you. Biddly boo. With a